Hello, Scorpio. Welcome back to my channel. We're doing your next 48. This is episode 26 and 27 for Scorpio Sun, Moon, Rising, and North Node. So let's see what the messages are for Scorpio. Okay. Sun, Moon, Rising, and North Node, please and thank you very much. All right. Scorpio. Okay, one more. I feel like your cards are the cards are real sticky. Alright, let's see. I feel like you're in a sticky situation, Scorpio, is what I'm hearing. Alright, yeah, we have the, it could be about your career, or it could be about your father, or an earth sign, Virgo, Taurus, or Capricorn. Okay, you could have Capricorn in your chart. Alright, let's see. So we have the Two of Wands, and then we have the Queen of Cups. Okay, so. Oh my God, I saw something similar. I don't forget what who's reading this that was that I saw something similar to this. So, okay, so I'm getting this as someone else, and so is this is your energy here, Scorpio. It looks like you are getting to know someone, or you're getting to the bottom of a situation regarding your family or regarding your career. Okay. Because it's almost like if the King of Pentacles is your father or some type of father figure or a boss, or this could definitely be you. I feel like you're getting to know this person, or you're picking this person's brain. Because it's like you're coming at this person. You want to know something. You're asking questions. You're like, look, I want to know this. I need you to tell me this. I need clarity on a situation. Okay, let's see. Yeah, we have the Eight of Pentacles. It could be about your work. I'm getting you could be approaching your boss like, look, I need more hours. I need more money. Something has to give here. I'm not getting what I want. My needs are not being met. I'm working too late. I need to be with my family. Whatever this is, I'm getting, let's see. We have the Five of Wands, and then we have the Lover's card. Yeah, so I'm getting you need to talk to your family about someone that you love. Okay, because I'm getting an interracial relationship here, because I'm getting someone who is mixed of mixed blood, and then I'm getting maybe you are dark skinned, Asian, African, Jamaican, or maybe you are just somebody of African descent, and I'm getting a couple here that is interracial. So I'm getting you need to approach your father and your mother, or you need to approach somebody about these ideologies. Now, you know that now you're expecting a fight. You know it's going to be a fight. You know it's going to be chaos. You know you're going to have to face some demons and face some challenges. But I'm getting you love someone, and that's it just is what it is. Now, this person does not have to be of a different race, but I'm getting they have a very fair or light complexion. Or maybe you do, and you want to date black guys or whatever the hell, okay, or something. Okay, what's the Five of Wands? But I'm getting this is about something that you love to do, your work. And I'm getting you're not going to have a lot of support. There's going to be people who have a lot to say are against you, or against you want to do, against who you want to love, okay, against what you want to do for work. It's almost like you, okay, I want to see what the, Five of Wands first and foremost? What is the Five of Wands, please? Okay, we have the Seven of Cups is coming up inverted, which is really good. You've been living in an illusion. You've been living a lie. I'm getting like somebody's going to argue with you. There's going to be an argument here. There's going to be conflict about something, but it's almost like, look, I'm not confused anymore. I know what I want. I'm coming back to my senses. You can't confuse me any longer about this job or about employment or about my career or about love. I know what love is and I know what love is not. Because I'm getting you were confused about love, or you were conflicted. You were dealing with inner demons, inner turmoil. You were conflicted about who you wanted to love, where you wanted to work. How does love even work? You know what I mean? And it's almost like now you have clarity. You're not confused anymore. I'm getting to you're narrowing down your options. Maybe you were dating several people and you don't want to do that anymore. You want to be with one person that you have a very genuine connection with. The Lovers is a lover. Of course, it's a card of intimacy, and that is your realm, Scorpio. You do rule intimacy and sex and death. Okay, I feel like sex is a form of death too, especially for men, especially if you are spilling your semen, but that's neither here nor there. Different conversation, but I'm getting the Lover's card is a major arcana. This is a very impactful love. This is someone that came into your life and changed your life. It's impactful. It's not someone that you can just forget about, okay? So I'm getting that was meant to happen to cause some type of disturbance or to, I'm getting war and peace. Sometimes you have to be cruel to be kind. is what I'm getting here. Okay, what's the Two of Wands, please? What is the Two of Wands? So maybe somebody broke your crown, Scorpio. Like, I don't know. Maybe somebody gave you like the best intimacy of your life and you're like, wow, that sex really changed my life. And you're just like, I gotta have it. I have to have you. I have to be with you. Like, I don't care who's against me. Like, okay, so I'm getting like whoever, it could be a Gemini, okay, or a water sign, Piscean. Okay, what's the Two of Wands? What is the Two of Wands, please? Two of Wands. Yeah, the Ace of Swords. You have clarity. You want answers. You want answers now. I'm getting you are calling somebody on the phone and saying, look, this is over. I'm done with you. We're done. I'm in love with somebody else. Or like somebody is calling you on the phone wanting answers from you. It could be your mother or your father or both. But I'm getting this is you, Scorpio. I'm getting too, you're overhearing a conversation that you're overhearing like somebody talking about you on the phone. You're like, wait, what was that? What'd you say? Because it's almost like you get clarity because you overhear somebody else's conversation or you overhear somebody talking about you and maybe this person. And you're like, oh, wow. So it's like, so I'm getting like, yeah, but I'm getting you're not going to say anything right away. But it's almost like, wow, now you have clarity because you overhear a conversation. It's like you, I'm getting like you're in the bathroom stall and you hear something that you weren't supposed to hear. Or you were like walking up on something and you kind of stopped. But you overhear somebody on the phone talking about you and this person. And it's like, oh, wow, okay. Because it's almost like when I see the Five of Wands in this deck, it's like there's five wands, but only four people arguing. You're up here on the top. It's like you're eavesdropping or listening in on these people talking or arguing about you and this other person. And it's like, wow, now I understand what's going on. There's like some bullshit in the mix. I'm getting you overheard something at work that you weren't supposed to hear. Okay, what is the Queen of Cups? That's you, Scorpio. What are you doing? This is your card as well. That's the third Deacon of Scorpio, Seven of Cups. What is the Queen of Cups, please? The Nine of Pentacles. Yeah, being single. Okay, so it's almost like either this is you, Scorpio, or somebody else that you're dealing with. What is the Nine of Pentacles? Because that's usually the single card, being self-sufficient, self-reliant, being self-made, okay? Being able to stand on your own two feet. You don't need anybody. This is also to somebody who is on stage, praise, cameras, lights, action. Okay, what's the Nine of Pentacles? But I'm getting too like this. It could be a Virgo. Someone is standing here telling you something or you're like, whatever. So I'm getting like maybe somebody tried to warn you. You ignored them. I'm getting you turned your back on someone. It could be a friend, somebody who was trying to like give you advice or something. What's the Nine of Pentacles? It's like somebody was trying to make you more independent, but you were like, no, or something. What's the Nine of Pentacles? Yeah, the Three of Wands. It's like somebody was telling you that they were expecting. Someone's pregnant. And we have the Wheel of Fortune. So what I'm getting with this is you overheard somebody telling somebody else that they were pregnant, maybe not by you. It's almost like you heard somebody say, yeah, I'm pregnant, but it's not his, or I'm pregnant, but, or something like that. It's like you overheard somebody, or like you found out that somebody really wasn't pregnant at all. They were lying. They were just trying to create confusion or trying to keep you in a situation or trying to make you stay. Yeah, because someone's like, yeah, I'm expecting, but it's almost like, I don't know. Something is about to shift or change. Somebody shifted or something. I'm getting too, it's like somebody is a shifty character. Somebody shifts, shape shifts. I shift shapes, all right? But it's almost like something is about to change because of something that you heard. It's almost like you were expecting this, but it's like you just weren't sure. You didn't know what to believe. Or you didn't know if you could trust this person. But I'm getting now you have clarity because something that you saw or some type of phone call that you're getting. This can be like a phone call from Planned Parenthood or something. If you're young like that. Okay, what is the King of Pentacles, or like a doctor is calling you or a friend or something? What's the King of Pentacles? What is the King of Pentacles, please? Yeah, the Six of Pentacles. Six of Pentacles. Because this could be, yes, somebody, this is like someone's giving you like, someone's paying you for something, but I'm getting it's very meager because the King of Pentacles has it. He got that moolah, he got that bag, okay? It's Big Daddy, it's the King of Pentacles, it's the top of our chart, it's fame, it's Capricorn, the money bag sign, but I'm getting like somebody has a lot more than what they're leading on, and like somebody's giving you chump change, or this is you. I'm getting you could have been involved with an earth sign. But I'm getting like you were giving them the bare minimum, or they were giving you the bare minimum of their time, attention, wealth, whatever. I'm getting like somebody is loaded, but they were like giving you like chump change. Like for real, Six of Pentacles, that's like $50 or something. And somebody really, they really got that bag. Okay, so maybe this is you. Maybe you were keeping that a secret from this person because you didn't know what their aim was. You weren't sure if you could trust them. Okay, what's the Six of Pentacles? What is the Six of Pentacles? Yeah, we have the Hangman. Yeah, I'm getting somebody left you hanging because you were giving them the bare minimum of yourself, your time, your attention, money, whatever. Somebody left you hanging, or you were made to wait, or I'm getting to your money is being blocked. Like if you're waiting for money to come in, that's being blocked by the universe because you did not follow divine guidance. I'm getting somebody gave you clarity on a situation and you didn't believe them. So it's blocking your money. It's blocking your career. You're not getting jobs. You're not getting called back. You're making very minimum wage, very little money. And I'm getting you're frustrated behind this. You're frustrated. Okay, you're feeling beat up, bored, disinterested, depressed, apathetic, because you're not getting what you want as far as your career goes, because the universe is blocking you because you're not listening. I'm getting too like you created some type of confusion, or you made like somebody's life hell or something like that. So you're being blocked when it comes to your career or money, or maybe you did not focus on the right things. Okay, what's the Eight of Pentacles? I'm getting a lot of Virgo energy in your reading, or Taurus. Okay, what's the Eight of Pentacles? Yeah, the King of Swords. Yeah, so something about your work. I'm getting like somebody is approaching you at work like, look, you know, it's like you're focused at work and somebody is coming up to you. I don't know what the King of Swords is saying, but it's almost like you're trapped. And yeah, you're now, what is going on, Scorpio? What is wrong? It's like you're feeling guilty about something, or you feel trapped like you had no choice. Because I'm getting you tried to move up in your work, or you tried to move up in your career. So it's like you decided to, I don't know what you did. Maybe you made somebody's life hell, or you did something malicious to someone on purpose because you wanted to get ahead at work is what I'm seeing. But I'm getting this person genuinely loved you or something, but I'm getting, this is really worrying me, these cards coming out like this. What is the King of Swords doing? Because that's like, that shows me like you're in a state where you could be even having like suicidal thoughts or something. Like you feel really guilty about what you did, but it was only for you to get ahead in your career. And maybe you really screwed up or screwed somebody over or something. Okay, what's the King of Swords? What is the King of Swords, please? Yeah, the Ten of Pentacles. That's what I'm getting. I'm getting you have been working very hard on your career. You want the money, you want the fame, you want the attention, and I'm getting somebody came up to you and promised you, like, look, you know, you've been working really hard. Let me offer you this. I can, you know, let me make all your dreams come true. Let me marry you or something. But I'm getting you were focused on your work. You were working hard. You're very concentrated when you work. But I'm getting you just weren't getting ahead. You just weren't getting that recognition, or the money wasn't coming in fast enough. But I'm getting it was being blocked because you're not supposed to work for someone. You're supposed to work for yourself. Or maybe you're supposed to work with this person. Now this could be too somebody in your family coming up to you. maybe like micromanaging you, watching you now. It's like somebody, I don't know, it's, I don't know, something is going on. You feel stuck or trapped or bound to a situation and you're about your money or your family or your career. Because I'm getting you are feeling stuck, so you kind of, you try to take the easy way out or something. But then like something shifted, it didn't go the way that you planned. Okay, what's the Seven of Cups in reverse? Or it's not gonna go the way that you thought it was gonna go. Yeah, we have the Judgment. Yeah, it's not gonna, I'm getting you're gonna be judged for this. You are gonna have to answer for this. You are gonna have to be held accountable for what you did. For creating the confusion or for really screwing somebody over who showed you, who was honest with you or tried to help you or show you a better way. So I'm getting now you're like in your head, you're feeling guilty or I don't know, it's like the hammer's coming down on you or something. Or maybe you are realizing that, I don't know. What's the wheel? Yeah, the Hierophant. This is about commitment, religion, tradition, doing the right thing. I'm getting Taurus energy. It's like you didn't want to do the right thing. You went the opposite direction, like you went left. Now we do have Uranus in Taurus, and that is, this is very, this is, but the Judgment is Plutonian to me. Yeah, justice. Now I'm not getting, I'm not sure this is you or someone you're dealing with, but hopefully it's not you, Scorpio. Someone's gonna have to answer or pay for what they did. I'm getting it's a hefty price. It may be a huge loss or loss of a job or something, like a lot of money is going to be lost. Or you're gonna be like stuck in a career that you hate like for a certain amount of time. What's the Lover's card? Maybe I'm getting two, you're gonna have some type of contract with your family, maybe stuck working with your family for like 10 years or something like that, or doing something that you really don't wanna do. But the Hangman is like the universe. It's like for a time. It's, I'm not really sure how long. But you are going to be stuck, you are going to be blocked. And that's the karmic wheel. Okay, what is the Lovers? What is the Lovers, please, for Scorpio? Yeah, we have the Contract card coming out. So it's like, it's almost like you decided by your own accord to be in this contract and now you're blocked. The universe is like, now you have to wait for the Wheel of Fortune to come back around. You have to wait for that time to re-present itself. But for the meantime, you're going to be stuck. What's the Lovers? Yeah, the Seven of Swords and the Ace of Cups. You were lying to this person or keeping, you were keeping secrets or lying or just not being loyal or faithful. I'm getting to this as a lesson in being a liar or keeping things a secret or being too mysterious or causing confusion when it comes to love or intimacy. Yeah, we have the Contract card. It just keeps coming out. I'm getting you're supposed to work for yourself, and now you're going to be stuck working for another. I'm getting to you're going to lose your freedom. I mean, this could be jail or something, but I'm not getting that. I'm getting this is more so like you being stuck in your career. Okay, let's see. I am going to pull some Love Oracle cards, but I think I want to pull one from the Ancients first. Okay, let's see. Okay, this is Divination of the Ancients. So let's see. Yeah, we have fire, spontaneity. So this could be a fire sign. Something is going to happen like all of a sudden. I'm getting you were not expecting this at all. You weren't expecting the ship. I'm getting like, I don't know. It's like, I'm just trying to forewarn you here. This is a lesson about being fickle, playing with people's emotions, playing with, you know, playing with people's, intimacy, like somebody was intimacy. Maybe I'm getting you lied to get some in somebody's pants, or you confuse them or something. Or this is someone who did this to you. Yeah, we have healing. So maybe I'm getting like somebody tried to heal you, but I'm also getting two, somebody has healing sex, like the person that you slept with, it's like, I'm getting like you had sex with an angel, or you had sex with like a supernatural being in the form of a person, but I'm getting that sex kind of, I don't know, I don't want to say it bounded you. I'm getting like karmic sex here. Like the sex was karmic. Okay, let's see. I'm gonna put a love oracle card for you, Scorpio, okay? Yeah, we have release your expectations. And you could have too been lying and saying, yeah, I'm gonna leave my ex, but you were sleeping with multiple people. I'm getting to release your expectations. So like, I'm not really sure what this is, but it's almost like you were expecting something to go a certain way, but it's just not gonna go the way that you planned. Yeah, I'm getting you met your soulmate and you took it for granted because you didn't want to release something that was toxic, or maybe you did not want to release other sexual partners in your life. Yeah, we have forgiving and learning. Yeah, so, I mean, the Wheel of Fortune always comes back around. This is a opportunity for you to forgive and learn from the situation. Yeah, we have chemistry. So when something is beautiful, let it be beautiful. Like I'm getting you were falling in love and you kind of, I don't know what happened here. Okay, we do have soulmate, we do have chemistry, but I'm getting you were expecting something to go wrong and it went completely, I don't know, Scorpio, okay? I'm gonna leave it there. Hopefully the video helps you. Don't forget to like the video, leave your comments, and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Bye.